for mechanistic thinking. I wanted to demonstrate that the roots of
Alexa, stop please. Hi, my name is Crystal and welcome to my YouTube channel. Sorry I didn't do a video yesterday, but I was viewing my father's body who has died on the 25th of August 2021. I was viewing my father Derek's body in the co-op funeral service yesterday. Yesterday was very sad for me and it was a shock. So I took a taxi from my mum Jennifer's at Dowell Gardens, and he drove me straight outside the co-op funeral service. Hold on a minute, Alexa, what's the time, please?
It's 9:17 a.m.
It's 9:17 a.m. And Alexa, what's the date today?
It's Tuesday, the 14th of September.
May I say, this is a really, really sad time for me, and I'm getting a lot of stress and people being silly and stupid and still carrying on like I need a hood over my head and I've just lost my father. It's very difficult. So I went inside the co-op service. There was a blonde lady with a mask over her face. Really nice young ladies. Showed me into this room with a key. He was locked, his body was locked inside Arethusa room in the co-op. So he was in the Arethusa room. The coffin was plastic, brown plastic with gold effect plastic. My father's body was too big for the coffin, so his legs were bent. They bent the bottom of his feet to fit in the coffin. So his feet were twisted at the bottom. He had warders laid around his leg, so they hadn't taken the tags off. He still had tags off of his body, where he was probably in the Medway Maritime Hospital mortuary. And he had warders laid tied round his leg. Excuse me, I've got builders working outside and one of them is laughing while I'm doing this video. My father was 6'1½" and the coffin was obviously too small for my father, so his feet were twisted at the bottom. My mum had given the funeral directors clothes to put on my dad. He had a pair of old brown slippers on his feet. He had a pair of grey bed trousers and a cricket jumper. And they had indeed done his hair and trimmed his beard and his nose. Something had happened to my father's nose. So it all had makeup over it. It had like foundation coloured makeup over his nose. And his eyelids were stitched shut. Now you've got to remember that my father's body was over 3 weeks old and it was probably deteriorating. To me, the face did not look like my dad. I know it was my dad. I know it was because I recognised the forehead and the hair and the fingernails. My dad's hands, but it didn't look like my dad. And the solution that the embalmers use is formaldehyde mixed with other chemicals. And when I walked into that room, and one of the females said she would sit in with me, but I just didn't know what to expect. The smell of all the chemicals made my eyes water. It got stuck in my throat and I couldn't breathe. So I could only stay in that room 5 minutes max. The smell was a tiny locked in space with no air, no windows. So he was tightly shut in a room with no windows and no air. And my mother, Jennifer, can't breathe properly. She has a severe breathing difficulty. My mum does, and my mum couldn't have gone in there. So I walked in, I said, I'm Janestra, Derek's dad. Derek's my dad. I've come to view Derek, my dad's body. I was taken into this room, plastic table, plastic artificial flowers, tissue box. I can't remember even seeing a chair to sit on. The candle wasn't lit. There was a burnt out tea light candle, it wasn't lit. And it was very, very claustrophobic, with no window and no air, and the smell of formaldehyde mixed with other chemicals. My mum said she'd asked them to put lavender on his body. It didn't smell of lavender, it smelled of chemicals, potent chemicals. So I stayed in there 5 minutes max, and I had to rush out and get some fresh air. And I felt high. High, I couldn't see properly, I couldn't think. And my hands were shaking, and I had to walk home from the co-op funeral service back to Corey's Road after having the shock of seeing my dad like that and the smell of all those chemicals. His eyelids were, like I said, sewn shut, and it wasn't covered up, you could see, and there was makeup like foundation all over his eyelids. It was horrible and horrific. I told my mum, to me it looked like something out of a horror show. That did not look like my dad. That was not a true representation of my father. He never had a perfumed beard. It was always messy. His hair was always messy. And I couldn't see if they'd done his toenails because his feet were all twisted at the bottom of the coffin. And the coffin lid was stood on the wall. Derek Trower died 25th of August 2021, aged 75 years. And the coffin lid was laid against the wall. My father was in the plastic coffin, plastic, with like lace effect over the body and over the coffin. But I do have to understand that the body was over 3 weeks old and it didn't look like my dad. It was, because I recognised the fingers and the forehead and his hair, but the face was all squashed and it was horrific. And I'm going to take a long while to recover over seeing that. Today, the funeral is at Bluebell Hill Crematorium at 2:30, where Derek Trower is being cremated.